flavor for today?
San Quinto. What's that? Watermelon?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Go to ironatofself.com, man. Sidewalk Crackers back. Clearly, this motherfucker knows nothing about marketing.
I know about lifting. I'm not an influencer. I actually lift.
We were spoke. But he has the cutest cup. Let me see the cup. He has the cutest cup.
Y'all got instructions on there. It says 30 minutes before you lift anything.
It don't say that on here.
It should.
It shouldn't, because it get right to that system. Yeah. IronAdictSubs.com. Go there, get you some Sidewalk Cracker, man. We got something coming up brewing. Make sure you take your ass there. I need all of it bought up. If y'all want the fat burners, the pump, if y'all want all that, go ahead. This is not merch neither. We threw this together, man, for an event. This is not merch, but merch will be coming soon too. And sonsofabeast.org. Make sure you go follow that. We got Sam here today who has never, ever, ever did anything correct. We ain't advertising right. We not. Man.
Influencer you, bro.
I'm not an influencer.
You're an influencer.
No, I'm not. I am a YouTuber. No, I ain't even that. See, I gotta find a space that I'm in, bro. I don't wanna be connected to none of this shit. I'm a guy that posts videos on YouTube. And with doing so, I hope to touch and reach as many people and build a community of positivity, sidewalk cracking, taking motherfuckers, and people who are about change and rocking with that. Who?
Your fan base.
You're right.
You don't have a community of positive
people. No, you know, you see, this is where you're wrong.
You don't have a fan base of positive people, dog.
You're right. My fan base is terrible. You know why? Because my friends are the thousands that follow me. My fans is the one that hate on me over here. So you're right. I don't have fans, bro. Fans switch it up on you. Your homies, the community that they have built around me. It takes a village.
But you said you want a positive community.
That's my community.
Everybody in your comments want smoke, dog.
They get it because that's what we do. Bad marketing.
We're here with a Save A Lot water bottle.
We about to have some. So depending on the way we trying to maximize the most reps at, what we do is we work up to a good weight and then do a top set. So today, I'm gonna go a tad heavier and we're gonna do the failure sets down. So what we do is we work up. What I've learned is you wanna feel the heavier weight in your hand before you just do like a couple warm-up sets and jump to it like we used to do. And that was not maximizing the most that we can get out of the failure set. So feeling that, and you got a central nervous system, motherfucker. So it does get affected. You'll go from a 225 or 315 warm up, try to put 485 on the bar, and you ain't even touched 400 yet. So now your body is telling you like this shit too damn heavy. And really, it may not be that heavy. It may be just because your central nervous system ain't geared up to the weight you're putting on. So this is what we start doing. I'm gonna see where I go, man. This little underwear I got on my arm and KT tape should have me together. And again, let me show y'all, motherfuckers, man. This is not what these motherfuckers be using and talk, you know, this is not equipped. This is from motherfucking Walgreens, bro. This is an old motherfucking arthritis compression arm.
Thank you.
So here's a quick lesson. Breathing, man. So I was moving on for 8 to 10, but when I brought it down, I took a breath. When I pushed it out, I didn't blow it out. So therefore, my asshole grew about 4 more inches, and I moved my liver to the right. So breathing techniques, man, I know better. Coming from mixed martial arts, punching, breathe on impact. And I did not do so. So breathing is a big part of it, especially if you're a rep dude. I only did 7. I hate odd numbers. I literally could not catch my breath. It was like I was drowning. So make sure you breathe in every rep.
Let's go. Come on.
Yep. Throw that shit around. Plane.
Respect. It's too much respect, man.
You respect it, man.
I feel like I'm throwing it around. No, I'm not.
Go
crazy. Here's another thing, and I just had a bad training partner moment. I know better. I have to have somebody guided frontwards for me because of my range of motion. I pretty much, that's everybody, I'm assuming, because now Sam is struggling because I'm just sitting it up there and he's pulling it forward. So, guys, ask your guy, where do you like it, where do you like your place? And that way you can guide it right to where they need it. I need it right under my chest. And I honestly, in my mind, I was the only motherfucker with that problem. But what I did was took probably 3 reps from her, because that's a lot of fucking energy wasted trying to pull. That's not even natural to do, to try to pull it forward like that. So I take responsibility for screwing him. So at this 315, he better get 15 at least. We get down to 315. Because now that I know, I really thought it was just me, but obviously it's not. Then I can feel the difference. I can actually feel the difference when you pulled it. You gotta be a good spotter, man. I know better because I need a good spotter, so I take responsibility. So, good spot. Like I said, man, know your part, guys, and just don't let anybody spot you. If y'all see somebody spot me, very rarely have I just let anybody spot me. that little oversized fucking 16-year-old that be swatting me, he knows. He knows. Sam knows. So you gotta have a good spot, man. And if you can, and this particular goes to the guys who's trying to get maximize the most out of their reps, always use a spotter. I had talked to Gage about this. Indio Gage, y'all look him up, Gage the Juggernaut. I talked to him about this. Yeah, bro, it's awesome you can pick 585 up by yourself. But I guarantee you can do way more if somebody actually spots you. So don't spot is not an ego thing, bro. Spot will help you get the weight, because regardless of the fact if it's a good spot or not, all you're doing is taking off the bar and let them pull it to where you need it to be, and the rest is on you. So make sure y'all got a spot. If not, ask somebody and coach them through it. You know where you want that bar at. And stop, and don't get no pussy ass motherfucker to spot you either. Cast a C3 place on there and be scared of the shit. Like, motherfucker, give me the shit, I'm good. So that's another tip for the day. The greatest bench pressers in the world. Speed reps, endurance reps are different from one press max. Pause, lockout, rack. That's one press max. Right? Speed reps, bang, bang. You do not. And you know, people kill me with that weird idea. If you locked out, you only do 30. If I locked out, I would only do 30, and that'd be my last 30 ever. This is 435 pounds went up today. 405 went up today. There's two different styles of training. And I understand most of y'all don't know shit. I get that. I get most people don't know. I didn't know. But this is the reason why I got these goddamn thongs on my arm now. And I can't shave the back of my head on that side. I can't touch my nose. I gotta get injections in my elbow. Why? Because some stupid motherfucker told me that doing endurance reps, speed reps, you're supposed to snap on your fucking elbows. You're not. You cannot take tendons out of your body and replace them. You don't want that problem. Because if your goal is to look good or whatever, then just fucking pump. Okay? Again, I do not condone these reps. I don't condone those. The dance and shit. But bro, you're not supposed to tear these tendons, man. I don't know what the fuck wrong with y'all. Just because you can't do it. That's really, because no real bench pressers ever comments. So listen, for those of y'all who want to listen, y'all doing speed reps, bro. Pump. And again, if your chest don't look better than the people you fucking talking about, shut the fuck up. So here's something that I'm guilty of not inclining. focus on straight chest, but moving forward in this particular program, start adding incline movements. I'm not incline benching, really is not my shit. It really is not good for my shoulder. Now I know everybody is opposite. The incline for some people, better for the shoulder, not for me. Like not even a little fucking bit. So I will use the hammer strength, start working in dumbbells to have a complete chest. Now, I ain't gonna do no decline. Like that's, you think there's benefits in decline, Sam?
Zero.
I just.
You gotta fuck your shoulder up.
If you trying to look cute, yeah, I'm far past cute, man. My mama think I'm handsome, so can't none of you motherfuckers tell me. So I don't need a fucking super cap chest. I need these reps to go up. So I'm gonna keep it with flat and incline, man. And just burn the shit out. So again, these things that we talk about that we have seen work for us, I'm not saying it worked for you. So you can try to use different things like I've done, but I got so many reps without inclining. Now I'm at it and see if that helped with my progression. So that's it, man. That is our chest routine. Okay, that's one of them. Like I said, we progressed up. Keep the reps low if you are doing failure sets. Don't get out there because you're feeling good and just bang out something. I will keep no less than five. No more than five, I'm sorry. I would do no more than five. All right, then when you get to the top set that you want to do your failure sets on, break that bitch all the way back down to 225, man. Go to failure. I had some great numbers today. I was a bad spotter because I normally like to talk shit about him. But I was a bad spotter. So one of the tips was absolutely, at least I can admit it. One of the tips is actually have a good, ask your guy where he wants to wait. And you make sure they hand it to you where you need it to. That is huge, that's important, that's a lot of energy exerted. All right, you gotta be lightweight bougie if you're on the bench, okay? No problem. But make sure you do that. Make sure you get a good flow in the blood. I like to do the lats. I like to get my lats tight. I know a lot of people don't think the lats help out with the bench. I like to get some blood in the lats to get the good stretch. Y'all know I'm stiff as hell, but I'll still whoop your ass. Black Belt Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, don't get it twisted. What they talking about, bro? But anyway, like, subscribe to YouTube channel, ironatitself.com. Sidewalk Crackers is out here. Man, trust me, we on the move next week. Well, actually, when this video releases, we'll be on the move this Saturday to Westland, Michigan, Westfit, 2-4. What else we got? Sonsofabeast.org. Merch is coming back. Everything is happening. 2024 about to be great. I know a lot of people say that, and then they be doing the same shit. They be waiting to say that shit again. January 4th, they be like, man, 225 gonna be great. Nah, motherfucker, 224 gonna be great for real, man. Stay tuned, man. Appreciate everybody who likes, subscribe to the channel. Sorry we did two chest day videos in a row, but that's what the schedule had permitted us to do, so fuck you if you're mad at me. All right.